sanctuary on a Sunday. Stand to your feet. Now, I don't know what you've been through this week. I don't know the circumstances. I don't even know what you're going to face this next week. But I know this, that God is here and He's going to do a great work. Today, you're going to get exactly out of the service what you put into it. If you don't put anything in, you're not going to get anything. I don't know about you, but I need the Lord today. I need the Spirit today. Today, we are so honored that Indiana Bible College is with us. Come on, let's give them a sanctuary welcome. Let me tell you what they're not doing today. They are not performing for us. If you came for a concert, you might want to leave right now. We're going to enter into praise and worship with them. I believe miracles are going to take place today. We have at least two being baptized in Jesus' name at the end of this service. Let me share something with you to give God glory. In the last 3 months, we baptized more this year than the last 2 years for the whole year combined. God is doing something at the sanctuary. So what I want you to do right now, I want you personally to lift your hands to heaven. I want you to ask God to get your heart prepared for about what's ready to take place. In Jesus' name, God, I thank you for these students who have come. They have dedicated their lives to your work. But today, let there be absolute freedom of the Spirit. Let there be no distractions today. I ask you, God, to work in our hearts and our minds and our spirits. I ask you, God, to work miracles in this place. I ask you, God, let our flesh get out of the way so that your Spirit can have its way. We come to you today with IBC.
As long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. Sanctuary in Columbus, Indiana. It is an honor and a privilege to worship with you. Why don't you go ahead and turn to the person next to you and say, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise his name. There's an old song that says, when the praises go up, his glory comes down. And that's my prayer for this service today, that as we invite his presence here, that his glory falls down, that his power falls down. Hallelujah. So why don't we, before this next song even starts, why don't we take a minute and bless his name? God, we're here this morning to glorify your name. We pray that you would be exalted in our worship. Your name would be glorified. Hallelujah, Jesus.
He has done. gave a heavenly breath, and now it's air in our chest. That's why we're singing it back to you. For every battle you won, and everything that you've done, and everything that you're gonna do. Seen too much to ever doubt it.
The name of Jesus. Lord, we lift up your name and we praise you because we know who you are and we know the power in the name of Jesus. Lord, we give you glory. We honor your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Matthew 26, we see Jesus on trial. And what has happened at this point is his clothes has been rent off of him and the crowd has beat him and spit upon him. In verse 68, it says that they mocked him openly. And they said to him, "If thou art truly the Christ, tell us." And at this point, he was blindfolded, and they began to smack him on his head, and they smote him, it says, with the palms of their hands. And they said, "If thou art the Christ, tell me, who has smote thee on thy head?" What they didn't know is at the same exact time, while they all watched and waited for a silent God to fail, is that Peter was denying Christ and fulfilling the exact prophecy that he had foretold before the chapter. And Christ goes on, obviously, and takes on our sins on the cross, and what seemed like our greatest defeat, the church's greatest defeat, turned around for our greatest victory. So I'm here to say today that it doesn't matter if it were a promise or a prophecy, that when God says it, it's gonna happen. He said, "I'll destroy this temple, but in 3 days, I'm gonna raise it up again." So whatever God has spoken to you, be sure to know that if he said it, it's gonna happen.
Jesus. A few years ago, there was a woman, and she was in the last stages of pancreatic cancer. And she went to the doctor, and they said, "You don't have a lot of time." But this woman so desperately wanted to see her children graduate. And while this woman didn't, she didn't know the Lord, but she knew a man at her work who knew how to pray. And this man just so happened to go to my church. And she called and reached out to him and said, "Would you please pray for me? I'm at the end of my rope. I don't know what else to do." And while this woman had over 200 tumors in her body, this man said, "We're going to pray and we're going to believe." And he prayed for her and he gave her a prayer cloth that had been prayed over and fasted over for 3 days. And this woman went back to the doctor and they said, "Ma'am, we don't know how to explain it. We don't know what happened, but you are completely healed. There is no cancer in your body." And while the doctors may not know what happened, I do. And his name is Jesus. He healed in the Bible and he'll do it again. He raised people from the dead and he'll do it again. He made a way where there was no way and he'll do it again today because that is what he is famous for.
There is no fear, 'cause I believe. There is no doubt, for I have seen your faithfulness. My fortress, over and over. Faithfulness.
Thank you.
the highest praise. Maybe this is your first time in the sanctuary and you wonder what's happening. I expected pretty praise. I expected everyone to be calm and orderly. You got to understand where he brought me from. I was lost, I was a sinner, but I came to an altar and he restored my life. Work. Your hands work? Your voice works? Everyone bring him praise. He's so worthy of. I'm just glad to be at the sanctuary on a Sunday. We are so glad to have IBC with us. They came with anointing and power. Brother Anderson, thank you. We're going to hear from him in just a moment. But right now, we're going to worship in a different way. We're going to give a good offering to the Lord because he's worthy. I need everyone just to back up a little bit. You know that a tradition here. Right now, we're going to put the text to give on the screen. Today's offering, part of what you're giving towards, is to give it to this group. I appreciate the sacrifice they made to be with us. And not only are we going to give them an offering, we're going to serve them a nice buffet lunch. We're going to bless them. I want you to take your phone out right now, and I want you to text a gift that will go to help this cause. If you have cash, our usher's going to come right now. What we're going to do is we're going to receive an offering. We're going to take an intermission, a short five-minute break where you're going to greet each other. Can I get an amen? And God's going to work. Now, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to pray over this offering. Because what we're about ready to do is we're about ready to praise with our giving. Lord, I thank you so much that these students have sacrificed to be here today. And now we are blessing your kingdom through our giving. And we're asking you to do a great work in the rest of this service. In Jesus' name, and everyone say, amen.
Praise the Lord, everyone. We are thrilled to be with you at the sanctuary today on behalf of the president of our college, Reverend Joshua Carson, and all the faculty and staff at Indiana Bible College. We greet you and say thank you so much for supporting the educational ministry of IBC. Actually, all through the years now, you have done that. This is my 26th year I'm completing as the Dean of Worship Studies at IBC. And I can tell you that the sanctuary has been a blessing to us many times during that time. And we thank you so much for your kind hospitality. And just basically, we love being here to worship with you today. I want to give honor to Pastor Matt and Sister Becca Johnson. Thank you so much for allowing us to be here. And my daughters went on an IYC trip with them, and what a wonderful time they had. They fell in love with y'all and love you so much. And we're expecting some great years here with our relationship with the sanctuary with you. And I do also want to honor Bishop and Sister Mitchell, longtime friends that I love so much, and more than just a neighboring pastor-friend relationship. If I felt like I was in trouble, he would be on speed dial. So I know you feel the same way. Aren't you thankful for your pastor and bishop, your leadership here at the sanctuary? I also want to take a moment to give honor to your worship ministry here at the sanctuary. I've been blessed watching videos, and your Christmas concert was amazing, and I loved it so much. I know much of that is because of your leadership, Brother Matt and Sister Tamara Gordon, and I love them so much. And wherever you serve here at the sanctuary, if you're on the worship team, behind the scenes, or on the platform, I want to give honor to you today and thank you for your service to the kingdom. Would you let them know that you love and appreciate your worship ministry team? IBC has quite a discography, and we have just released our latest recording. The title of it is Worthy. We're going to sing the title song as our last song in just a minute. And the CD arrived Friday. So you are the first ones to have access to it. We'll have some out at a table today. Just an inside note, the people who were supposed to bring it and bring the money bag and the credit card machine and all that, I'm not pointing any fingers, but hold the CD up. They kind of fell through on it. But we had another young man, thank you, Brother Zach Cunningham, for running the CDs down here for us when he got out of church at Calvary today. And so we will have them today. We won't have any change at first or anything. And but we can do Cash App if you want a Cash App or something like that. If you're interested in IBC, we've had a lot of amazing students come from this church that have attended IBC. If you're interested, just stop by and ask any of these students in the blue corral uniforms or myself. We'll be happy to answer any questions for you. Before we start to sing, I do want to give an opportunity for all of the alumni, or if you're currently attending IBC, would you stand in the room? We'd like to see who you are. If you've ever attended IBC or you're currently attending, we have quite a number of them. We love you so much. I also would be remiss if I did not give a shout out to my angel, Cheryl Strevel, who blessed me so much years ago when I was so sick and felt like God led her to us. And Christy and I will forever be indebted to her for her kindness. The next song is probably my favorite. It's based on Psalm 91. Some of the lyrics include, "I shall not fear the arrow by day." It's very timely for the time we live in. "Nor the terror by night. Our God governs angel armies and sends encampments around me. Whom shall I fear?" Aren't you thankful that we have a God looking out for us? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I shall not fear.
Angel of God. name of Jesus in this place. Lift up the name of Jesus. God, we give you all the glory and honor. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yeah. because he's never lost a battle. God, you're so worthy in this place. Woo!
As we approach the last song of the night, or the afternoon, there's a verse that I want to share with each and every one of you. It's 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 7. It says this, casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. No matter what you're going through in this place, there is a God who cares for you. One of the worst things that we can do as a Christian is to believe in a God that is so far, so distant, so powerful and mystical that he doesn't care about the day-to-day life, that he doesn't care about what's going on in my life. But I've come here to tell somebody today that he cares about each and every one of you. No matter what you're going through, God is here in this place. This song was birthed out of Revelation chapter 4 and 5. And it talks about blessing, honor, glory, and power unto the Lamb forever. Now, it's a revelation that John had received about a future place. This book is purpose, and its time is in somewhere else. But I've come here to tell somebody today that we don't have to wait until we get to heaven to praise God. We can praise him right now. And so as they begin to sing this song, whatever you need, you can come up to the front. You can lift a hand up in the air, and you can praise him. You can receive your miracle because he is worthy.
Holy, high above
there are miracles in this house right now. If you will fully submit to Him at this altar, He will do the work. If you don't submit it to Him, He cannot do it. You've got to fully submit to Him. In the name of Jesus right now, God. I submit to You right now. I humble myself in Your presence, Almighty God. Move through this place. I give myself to You completely. You are the King. You are sovereign. You go before me. I trust in You. Ready to start.
First of all, we want to give God the praise because this young man just got filled with the Holy Ghost. And I I now baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for remission of your sins in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Woo! In Jesus' name, I invite you. The water is ready. But I'm going to make one more appeal to someone in this house because I cannot get away from it. You need an answer. And you've been holding back just a little bit. And you need prayer today. I don't care where you're at. If that's you, I want you to lift your hands. If you just need some extra prayer. Come on, look around. Look around. Find these individuals right now. They're saying, I need an answer. And I don't know what may be holding them back. If you need to go, if you have plans, I understand. But right now, we're going to have a time of prayer. And we're going to see miracles take place. I need someone so desperate, you don't care about the time right now. A desperation that says, before I leave today, I've got to have peace in my mind. Before I leave today, I need this miracle. Before I leave today, this depression has to leave. Before I leave today, this family situation's got to be out of the way. A cry of desperation. In Jesus' name. Thank you. I need some prayer warriors right up here to help me pray over a situation. I need some prayer warriors right now to help me pray. God knows the need, and He's going to do it right now. In Jesus' name. Before we're dismissed, I want to pray for these students. Some of them are at a crossroad right now. And they get up and they sing and they put on their best face, but some of them back home and in their life, they're dealing with stuff. And I want the Lord to bless them. And you came to minister to us, but God's going to minister to you right now. All across this place, I want you to find them. They're easy to find. They're in those gowns. Come on. It says IBC on it. Come on, I want you to pray over them right now. You don't know what they're facing, but God does. For some of you, it's direction in your life. For some of you, it's frustration you've been dealing with. For others of you, you've been hurt, and you need God to restore you. For other of you, you're worried about your finances and how God's going to bring you through. God will bring you through. Thank you. those who are still praying, be mindful of that. You're dismissed. Everyone else, in Jesus' name, they're going to continue to play. Thank you for being here today in the sanctuary. Be here Wednesday night. Our new sermon series begins. God's going to do great things. Greet these students as they leave.